हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल, हैव अ नाइस डे. वेलकम टू इंग्लिश कुमार भारती स्टैंडर्ड 9. स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव कंप्लीटेड ऑलरेडी आवर 2 यूनिट्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर न्यू यूनिट, यूनिट नंबर 3. एंड इन टू दैट यूनिट नंबर 3 देयर इज़ अ वेरियस काइंड ऑफ द लेसन्स एंड पोएम्स आर. सो आवर फर्स्ट पोएम इज 3.1 सिल्वर, रिटन बाय वॉल्टर डी ला मेयर. सो दिस इज द पोयम. इन टू दैट पोयम द पोएट हैज़ डिस्क्राइब्स द ब्यूटी ऑफ द मून लाइट नाइट एंड हाउ द मून हैज स्प्रेड हिज ओन लाइट ऑन द अर्थ एंड हाउ इट वैनिश्ड. द लाइट ऑफ द मून हैज वैनिश्ड द डार्कनेस ऑफ द नाइट and one kind of the pleasant atmosphere the moonlight spreads everywhere. In this poem also the poet has been compared the moonlight with a woman who has been walking slowly quietly in the night. So let's get started our poem. So first understood the little bit information about our poet. Our poet name is Walter D. La Mare. He was born in 1873 in England and he died also in England in 1956. He was an English poet, short story writer and novelist for the children and the adults. The poem Silver was first published in 1913 in his book for children Peacock Pie. The Bookworm program conducted a poll to find the nation's favorite poem, and that is the Silver in 1995. This poem Silver has voted the 63 out of top 100 poems. So the Walter D. La Mare's work is characterized by the appreciation and observation of the thing. His children's books and the horror stories are widely acclaimed. Memories of Midgate and Collected Stories for Children, The Traveler are the example of some of his celebrated work. So this is the picture of our poet Walter D. La Mare. As I said earlier, his full name is Walter John D. La Mare. He was born 25th April 1873 at the Charlotte, Kent, England. He died 22nd June 1956 at the age of 83 at the Twickenham, Midlakes, England. So here is the notable work of his given: James Tait Back Memorable Prize and Carnegie Medal. So these are the notable awards he was get. So this is the information of our poet. So let's get understood the meaning of the poem. Student, it's a beautifully picturized poem. And in this poem, the poet has picturized the moonlight very beautifully. And it's very simple and easy kind of the poem. First, we have to understood what is the importance of the moon. Students, when we woke up at that time, we see the light of the sun. And when the sunlight has comes, it disappears the whole the darkness. But when at the night, when the moonlight has come, at that time, it also vanish the darkness of the night. If there is a new moon time, means there is no moon into the sky, at that time, at night, it seems very horrible and it seems that everywhere there is a darkness into the sky. But when there is a beautiful moonlight spreads everywhere because of the moon. There is a different kind of the shades of the moon we see into the sky, and though there is a different kind of the shades of the moon, still some kind of the moonlight or the moon has spreads its light everywhere, and so it is one kind of the pleasant atmosphere comes at night because of the moonlight. So see the information about the moon. As we hear the name of the moon, a lot of things comes in our mind. So many things, the pleasant atmosphere, the beautiful breeze, that beautiful light has, that all, so many things comes into our mind. So in the moonlight, we sleep at the terrace, we looking at the moon, so all that things has comes in our mind. Just like the sun, the moon is also important to us. It gives cool light at us at night. In India, the children call it Chanda Mama. A lot of stories, myths, poems, songs had been made on the moon. Some describe this it as a man, but some describes it as a woman. In the poem Silver, the poet has described the moon, it means moon, as a woman. Because of the moonlight, everything on the earth looks in a silver color. As in the morning and evening, the sun makes the surrounding in crimson color. The moon does same at the night. Means when in the morning, when the sun rises in the east, at that time, the sun has totally covers whole thing by his own color. Means that oranges or some kind of the crimson, specially called as a crimson color, the sun has spreads everywhere. And it feels very energetic to us. And like that, the moon has also spreads its pleasant kind of the silver light everywhere. See, you can see the two pictures, two different pictures, that two things are important to us. The sun is important to us also, as well as the moon is also important to us. The sun has, when it rises in the east, it spreads everywhere his crimson or orange kind of the color everywhere, and it gives a energetic environment. And at the night, though there is a different kind of the shades of the moon, it spreads the some kind of the pleasant silver color everywhere. And at that time also, the environment looks very pleasant or pleasant in the air. So let's get started to our poem. So students, our poem name is Silver. It has a 14 lines. The 7 small stanzas are there. Each stanza has a 2 line. So total 14 line that poem is. And it's a very much simple and easy to learn kind of the poem. So first I read the poem. You have to pay attention on it. Slowly, silently, now the moon walks the night in her silver shoon. This way and that she peers and sees silver fruit upon silver trees. One by one the casements catch her beams beneath the silvery thatch. Couched in his kennel like a log, with paws of silver sleeps the dog. From their shadowy coat the white breast peep of doves in silver feathered sleep. A harvest mouse goes scampering by with silver claws and silver eye. And the moveless fish in the water gleam by a river reeds in a silver stream. This is the our poem which is written by Walter D. La Mayer. So let's get understood the meaning of the poem. Students, this is a beautiful picture which has been describes that our poet has been compared the moonlight with a woman, and into that the poet said that how the woman has been slowly quietly moving into the night time with her silver shoes, with her silver color dress. Like that the moon comes into the night very slowly, silently, and because of that slowly it comes up in the sky and it spreads slowly everywhere the silver color of its. And the poet here talks about the moon, or moon compares with the woman who is walking slowly, quietly in the night. Here the poet said that the night, into the night, whatever the things are there, living things are there, non-living things are there, which comes into the spotlight of the moon. It, because of that moonlight is like a silver color, and because of that silver color, each things had been glow into the night. They gets the glow into the night because of that silver color. Everyone in night time is like everything has been quiet and noiseless. There is a dark into the night, but that moonlight has spread its silver color, and because of that it creates the one kind of the glow into the night. The moonlight here describes the beauty of the dark night. So see the first two lines. Slowly, silently, now the moon. Means when the night time has been comes, at that time the moon comes very slowly, silently, upside into the sky. And when he comes up into the sky, what he has been done, walks the night in her silver shoon. Shoon means shoes. Means the poet said, poet has been compared the moonlight with a woman who has wearing the silver shoes. And she wears the silver color, and she spreads the silver color. And so the poet has compares the moon or moonlight with a beautiful silver color dressed woman, and who has wearing the silver shoes also. But the hidden meaning of that two lines is, the poet said that when there is a night time, at that time the slowly, silently the moon comes up in the sky, and when it comes up in the sky, at that time it comes very slowly, it walks very slowly, means it comes very slowly comes up into the sky, and when it comes into the sky, at that time it spreads its light everywhere, and that light color is the silver color. Means moonlight color is a silver color, and so the moon has spreads everywhere his silver color on the earth. See the second two lines. This way and that she peers and sees silver fruit upon silver trees. Student, peer means look. Means here the poet said that a woman who is wearing the silver color shoes, she comes and she peers, means she looks everywhere. She sees a silver color fruit upon the silver color trees. Means the poet said that when the moonlight comes up into the sky, at that time it spreads the silver color everywhere on the earth. It spreads the with a silver color on living things and on non-living things also. And so there is a trees are there, and when the moonlight comes on the trees, it looks like a silver color trees. And on that trees there are fruits. At that time the moonlight comes on that fruit also, and that fruits is also looks like a silver color. Means this way and that means anyhow the moonlight comes into the sky and it spreads everywhere. It looks and sees means the same meaning of the pierce and sees. That is the look. Means the moonlight anyhow comes into the sky and it spreads each and everything of the earth. Like it spreads on the silver trees, and it spreads also on the flowers, it spreads on the also on the fruits. And because of that silver color of the moon, if the things are also looks like a silver color, means silver fruits we see, silver trees we can see. See into that picture, you can understood that if there is a night time, there is all kind of the darkness has comes. But when the moonlight comes up into the sky, and when the moon has spread his own silver color on the trees are also looks like a silver color. Next line, one by one the casements catch her beams beneath the silvery thatch. Here the poet said that the light is comes everywhere on the each and everything. So the poet said that it also comes slowly and silently, it comes on the houses of the human beings. And if there is a long or big kind of the or small kind of the casements means was students' windows, especially the glass kind of the window, and when the moonlight comes on that windows or the casements, it catches the moonlight, and because of that moonlight it shines brightly. Her beams beneath the silvery thatch. Beams means the ray of the light. When the ray of the moonlight comes on that casements, it catches that light, and it literally that light comes on the window and it looks very shiny. That windows are looks very shiny, brighty, and it looks like a silver color of window. Thatch means what student? The roof made of grass or leaves. Means here the poet said that the moonlight comes, when the moon spreads its light or silver color light on, and it spreads everywhere, it also comes on the windows also. And the windows, when the light, the ray of light, that silver color light comes on the window, it looks like a beautiful silver color window. And it also, there is a roof which is made of grass and leaves. Into that picture you can see there is a roof which is made by the grass or leaves. And if the moonlight comes on that roof and on that windows also, the both looks silvery color. Couch in his kennel like a log. Couch means student what? Couch means laying down. Means kennel means the house of the dog is called as a kennel. Log means a piece of wood. Means there is a kennel outside of that house, and on that how into that kennel there is a dog has been laid down, means into that picture you can see couch in his kennel, means the dog has been laid down in his house or in his kennel. And it how the dog has been laid down, it looks like a log, it looks like a piece of wood, means there is a night time. Because of that night time, the dog appears like a log or it appears like a piece of wood. But when the silver color comes on his paws, means on his body, on his paws, if there is a silver color comes, when the dogs are sleeping and the paws are coming in front of his kennel, and when he sleeps at that time, on that paws there is a moonlight comes, and that paws also looks like a silver color, because only paws has been comes into the light of the moonlight, and so it looks like a silver color, and the kennel of the dog has been also looks like a silver color because of the moonlight. From their shadowy coat the white breast peep. Shadowy means what, students? Under shadow of the moonlight, means under the shadowy coat, means a bird shelter, especially a bird dove. There is a bird named as dove, their shelter or their nest called as a cot, means from their shadowy, means from there is a nest or there is a shelter of the dove called as a cot, comes into the shadow of the moonlight. At that time the white breast means white color bird. Who is white color bird? Dove is a white color bird. Peep means what, student? Look, means if there is a white color doves are there, they are sitting into their nest called as a cot, they are sitting into their cot, and this moonlight comes under on that dove, that the feathers of that dove has been looks like a silver color, means if there is a dark night they are looking like this, but if there some of the moonlight comes on their white feathers at that time, it looks like a very silvery, because the moonlight comes on the feathers of that dove. A harvest mouse goes scrambling by. Harvest mouse means, student, a mouse or a rats who are found into the fields, they are eating the grains of the fields. Is into the picture you can see, these are the harvest mouse who are living their life into the fields, and they are eating the grains into the fields. Scrambling by means they are running very quickly with a short tiny steps. So the harvest mouse is going here and there into the field with their silver claws and silver eye. They have the claws for their legs, they have claws, and their eyes, you can see their eyes are little bit bigger and it's shiny. And when this moonlight comes on that body, their eye and their claws are literally looks like a silvery color. Their body also looks like a silver color. Into the moon sunlight, they looks like this. And into the moonlight, they looks very silvery. Their eye also looks, it's very tiny but very much beautiful. And so if the moonlight comes on that eye, it looks like a silver color. Into the second picture, you can understood very well. And moveless fish in the water gleam. Students, you know what is mean by a stream. Stream means into the picture you can easily understood there is a stream. Or stream means small kind of the flow of the water which comes on the rocks. That is called as a stream. And reeds means what, student? The river side, there is a small kind of the different kind of the watery plants are there, and that is called as a reeds. Gleam means shiny. When there is a fish are being moveless into their stream, there is a moveless fish. Into the night time, there is a darkness spread everywhere, and because of the night, the fish are also looks like moveless. And so when the moonlight spreads its silver color, that everything, that moveless fish, that reeds, that streams also looks like a silver color. And this is the our poem. Hope you understood, students. Thank you.